In this video, I'll be demonstrating the new 0.4cc coupler, which is a new feature for the Affinity Compact. The main objective of what we wanted to achieve when developing the Affinity Compact was to capture trends which are happening both in our industry now and also into the future. And one of the most important trends that we understood or we realized was that the bandwidth is increasing in hearing aids. So hearing aids are playing and amplifying up to higher frequencies. There are a few different reasons for why you may want to do this, but some of them include, and the most important ones include, first of all, a more natural sound by achieving and amplifying those higher harmonics of speech. It gives a more naturally perceived signal and listening example to the user. It also contributes to better music appreciation, again because they're capturing those higher harmonics and higher frequencies. And finally, having higher frequency amplification gives a better ability for the listener to directionalize or realize where the sound is coming from when they're in an open space. We've captured this trend with our on-ear measurements through changing the REM headset to have microphones that measure up to higher frequencies and also higher frequency stimulation from the loudspeaker. But we also needed to include this trend and change in the coupler fitting area too. And we've done this both through introducing new microphones in our test box and also optimizing the loudspeaker to stimulate into higher frequencies. But one of the important factors that we want to talk about today is the inclusion of a smaller 0.4cc coupler on the Affinity Compact. Before I move on to explain how and what the 0.4cc coupler is doing, I just want to talk about what we're used to doing today. So we'll begin with the 2cc coupler. And we typically use this today because it's roughly the same size as an adult ear and same performance. And it's included in all the main standards, so ANSI and IEC approve its use, and you'll see it on hearing aid spec sheets. And the reason for this is because it's got a really nice and good reliable frequency response, up to 8 kHz. But now let's introduce the 0.4cc coupler. It's got a much smaller volume, which makes it more suitable for higher frequency measurements. It's still providing a nice, reliable measurement and frequency response in the lower and mid frequencies. And it has newly been included on standards by ANSI and IEC. And you may have seen this already, or you'll start to see it as things progress and new hearing aids get launched. And the really nice thing about this 0.4cc coupler is it can be used in exactly the same way as the 2cc coupler. So this is all nice and good in theory, but let's have a look at how these different couplers are performing in relation to a sweep stimulus. And the only difference between the measurements I'll be showing to you now is the coupler that's been used. So here's the frequency response of a 2cc coupler. You'll notice good stability of the measurement in the lower mid frequencies. However, when we get into the higher frequencies, and specifically above 8 kHz, you'll notice a drop in performance. This drop is due to standing waves, but we can talk about that a little bit more in a moment. Now let's look at the same signal, but with a 0.4cc coupler. And first of all, we can see the measurement is higher, but this is mainly because the cavity has a smaller volume, so it's naturally amplifying the signal more compared to the 2cc coupler. But we can also see that we have a good stability in the lower mid frequencies, but the main difference is that when we get above 8 kHz, there isn't a sharp drop in the curve that we saw with the 2cc. And it's this change that is allowing us to measure up into these higher frequencies, and above 8 kHz specifically. As I mentioned a moment ago, this drop is caused by standing waves in the coupler, and its presence may cause the measurement to fall below the noise floor, which means that the higher frequencies measured on a 2cc coupler aren't as reliable, so that then we're unsure about whether we're measuring the actual hearing aid amplification or the noise floor within the unit and your environment. So this is why we recommend a 0.4cc coupler when you want to verify this into the higher frequency area. Okay, all this information is good as a physical theory and a very technical viewpoint, but how do they compare when we're actually measuring the RECDs on our patient, and how do they differ when we're using a 2cc compared to a 0.4cc? So on this screen, we can see a 2cc coupler and a 0.4cc coupler, and their RECDs that they've generated from use of these different coupler types. Both have been measured on the same ear, and the only difference is the coupler that's been used. And you can see both that the ear curve and the coupler curve are in the background, and notice that the ear curve is the same on both and the coupler curve is different. The calculated difference between these two curves is what forms our RECD. It's a difference measurement between the two so that we can digitally apply this to simulate the ear. We're typically used to looking at a 2cc RECD curve, which starts around zero and it will increase positively as the frequency increases. And you'll notice in this curve that it is increasing positively, but when we get up into these higher frequencies, the RECD is overlapping the coupler curve, and this is really what we want to avoid. That moves us quite nicely onto the 0.4cc RECD, and you'll see straight away that it's a similar shape, but because the coupler is amplifying more, the RECD has dropped, so it's more negative because the coupler is more positive as a product, so when we minus one from the other. But typically the same advice can be applied. It starts low and it increases positively as the frequency increases. And importantly, you'll notice that there's no overlap here between the RECD and the coupler curve. So overall, it's okay that the RECD is negative to begin with for a 0.4cc RECD, but it should increase positively. Again, importantly, it shouldn't overlap that coupler curve, and this gives us the headroom to test into these higher frequency area with our hearing aids. Thank you very much for watching this video. Should you require further information, please contact your local Interacoustics support representative or the Academy website.